We've had an amazing time over the last 3 weeks visiting different continents in art, music, dance, and PE, learning about artists, cultures, countries, and sports. Let's cheer on the 205 countries participating in this year's 2021 Summer Olympics, including Team USA. Team USA. Team USA. Green Crayon says Team USA too. Let's pass on the torch. Kato two friends will work on a torch and flame illustration. Third to fifth friends will create a poster showing their support to Team USA. Team USA. And middle school friends will create a pencil drawing of a torch and flame. I'll see y'all on the drawing board. Hey friends, today we're gonna draw the Olympic torch and flame. And the Olympic Games was founded on the love of sport, unity, and competition in an ancient tradition of physical fitness. In 1936, the tradition of the torch relay began, and the torch gets lit from the basin of fire from the original location of the games in Olympia, Greece. And then the runner carries it to the host country of that year in the games as a symbolic race from the past to the present. So for today's lesson, we will need a blank sheet of paper, a pencil, an eraser, a Sharpie, and of course, something to create color. Today, I'm going to use a combination of my crayons and my color pencils. Let's go ahead and clear our board. And starting the torch and flame, the first thing I probably want to do is start with my flame. So my flame has almost a sideways teardrop shape. And then right here, I'm going to drop the flame down a little bit and then bring it back up. And then this line is going to connect with the outer line. So erase this line right here. And there's a flame on the inside as well, a little bit smaller. Wonderful. And our torch has a circular, almost cone-like, cylindrical look and feel. So I want to imagine that if I had a circle, and you're looking at the circle this view, this angle, but if I were to turn my circle a little bit this way, the shape, the original shape of that circle is no longer going to be a circle. Now it kind of looks like an oval, right? And I'm talking about the top of my fingers. See that shape? It's going to slightly turn and look. So it's no longer a full-on circle. Now it kind of looks like an oval. So to accomplish that, I'm going to create the illusion that this is 3D. So when I'm drawing my circles, they're actually going to look more like ovals. So that's one. There's two. Take this line off. And then now I want to do the side. So I have one line, two line that appears here. I'm going to connect those two lines. This is a big fancy word coming up. This is called parallel. So this bottom line is going to look almost like the top line. They're never going to touch. And now my cone is going to slightly look like they're coming in a little bit. I'll draw another parallel line. And now I want to have two diagonal lines going in the opposite direction, followed by a parallel curved line again. Two diagonal lines. parallel curve line again. And if this line was to disappear and I were to start it back here, because now it disappeared and now it looks like it reappears there, I want to do the same to this side. So if this were to disappear here and I continued my imaginary line, I would bring that line right back there. Right as you almost look like you're making a full triangle, we're going to stop right there. I'm going to put two diagonal lines this way, a parallel curve line, and then we're going to have a rounded base. Now I want to do some details. So I'm going to go in right here and I'm going to do some, this is called hatching lines. And the closer the lines are together, the more perspective or the more 3D your object is going to look. So I'm going to have these lines a little bit spaced apart and they're going to go all the way through. I'm going to do more hatching lines down here. And same thing, I want to draw these lines until they are complete all the way through on my curve. I will do some hatching lines down here as well. Awesome. And since my torch has a burning flame, I just want to have sort of like rays of light coming from my flame, and it's okay if it got cut off there. All right, and we are ready to outline. And I'll take my eraser and I'm just going to erase any pencil lines that may have been left behind. I didn't quite get it with my Sharpie, and sometimes that happens. So I'm not left with some pencil lines that I don't want on my drawing. Great. I'm going to have yellow, and I do like the color orange for the inside of my flame. So I'm going to use yellow on the outside. And I'm going to use orange on the inside, or this is more of a scarlet color. It's like a red orange. And I'm going to use orange and my red orange for my flame. So I'm going to very lightly press using the same scarlet color and go around the flame. And wherever the direction of the ray is going to go, that's the direction I'm going to also color or send my crayon lines through. Make sure my line is slightly curved first before I work on detail. And then now I'm going to take my orange and I'm going to blend the scarlet color in into my orange. And this is going to be the flame radiating away from the actual flame. Your rays of light, if you would. Perfect. And I'm going to use a combination of blue and gray and a little bit of black for my torch. So I'm going to go ahead and use blue for the base where my flame would be. And inside that blue, I'm going to very lightly add a little bit of black. I am not pressing really hard. I am just pressing very lightly. This is just to help create that illusion that there's a darker space right about there. Gives it a little bit more of a three-dimensional look. Wonderful. And I'm going to use my blue for the outside now. I'm not pressing quite as dark as I did the first time around with for the inside part of my blue. So you have to learn how to control the amount of pressure from your crayon. If you're using color pencils, same thing applies. You can use one material and get a variety of values that come out of it. Lots of lights and darks. And then I'm also going to take my gray and very lightly add a little hint of gray just to create more of a depth, that three-dimensional look. OK, Okay, I'm going to take my gray now and color the side of my torch. I'm going to color in two different directions. I'm doing a vertical direction, which is up and down. And then I also want to fill in my white spaces. So I'm also curving in a horizontal manner, but I'm really coloring in a curved way. And this is going to help create form, so your torch looks a little bit more 3D. I'm going to use my black crayon for a little part of this as well, same thing, up and down, and also in a curved way. Same thing for the bottom. Use my gray. And the hatching lines on this part here is really going to help create more of a darker area. So you don't have to press quite as dark with your black crayon. But it does give that nice illusion of three dimension. I'm going to use my blue here. Some silver, or some gray, I should say. Going back to my gray. And use black, of course, just a light hint of black. For the bottom of the torch as well. And then the last thing I want to do is use my color blue, my blue crayon, and I'm just going to lightly, very lightly add hints of it into my gray. Torch almost has a faint hint of blue, just very, very lightly. Okay friends, if you want to add color to the background, you can, or you can leave it white. I'm going to go ahead and add color to my background, and I'm going to use the color yellow. And I'm going to show you how to break your crayon. We're going to peel the paper off. I like to use this method when I'm trying to cover a large space a lot quicker, so I don't end up with a lot of crayon lines coming through. Here's my broken crayon. I love using broken crayons. So I'm going to sit my broken crayon on my paper, and I'm just going to rub the crayon against the paper. And that also gives me a really nice textured look for my background. I'm very careful when I'm coming around my lines. So you want to push and pull at the same time. And if you get a little bit of yellow into the flame area, that's okay. That orange is not going to show much of your yellow anyway. You might want to just be careful right around the blue areas, because yellow and blue make the color green. You don't want green happening. A little darker. Okay, and I want to do the same with the color orange. So here's my orange again. I'm going to break my orange. And peel the wrapper off, the paper off. And I'm only using orange for the bottom part and around the edges. It's gonna help create this glow, almost. Of course, if you wanna press a little bit harder, you can. So there's a really nice Olympic glow right around the torch and the flame. Almost has a chalk pastel look, if you would. Really nice and textured. Amazing. I can't wait to see what your torch and flame looks like. See y'all later. That was amazing. I can't wait to see your artwork. I can't wait to celebrate the 205 participating countries, July 23rd to August 8th. I'll say that again, July 23rd to August 8th. Till next time, friends, stay safe and have a great summer. Bye.
Bye.
Green Crayon says bye too.